Hi, in this session we are going to discuss the step 2 and step 3 for computation of performance values and importance values for our IPMA analysis or IPM important performance metrics in smart PLS. As we know that the indicator data determines the latent variable scores and their performances. Like see, we have this is our indicator, standardized indicator data, and then we have these are the individual scores. When conducting an IPMA on the indicator level, the mean value of an indicator represents an average performance. When computing average values on the contract or indicator level, it is important to remember that indicators may be measured on different scales. For example, some indicator may use a scale with values from 1 to 5, while others may use values from 1 to 7 or 1 to 10. To facilitate the interpretation and comparison of the performance levels, the IPMA rescales indicator scores on a range between 0 and 100, with 0 representing the lowest, and you can see in this map 0 representing the lower and 100 representing the highest performance. So we got a formula for the calculation of the indicator values, according to which we have to use for each indicator, we have to use the individual score of the respondent, actual score of the respondent. Like suppose if the respondent scored 4 on your scale, you have to subtract minimum value, which is 1 on from your actual response, and you will divide it with the denominator of the maximum value minus minimum value in 200. It is important to note that the minimum and the maximum values refers to the potential values on a certain scale. Example 1 and 5 on a 1 to 5 scale, and not the minimum and maximum values of the actual responses. Example 2 and 4 on 1 to 5 scale. Hence, if respondents use lowest actual response is 2, but the scale has a minimum value of 1, it is mandatory to use the 1 as a minimum value for rescaling. For example, according to this formula, a value of 4 on 1 to 5 scale becomes 75. Let's see how it's happened. Suppose in our original data, we got the actual response or score from the respondent for the first observation of the indicator is 4, for the second is 3. Let's find out after rescaling and using our formula what it will come. When you for our first actual response, if we subtract minimum value 1 from 4, so it will be, the formula will be 4 minus 1 divided by the denominator of minimum maximum value 5 minus minimum value 1 in 200, it will appear 75. Likewise, on the second observation for the first indicator, we got the actual response is 3. So how smart PLS has rescaled it? For 3, we do 3 minus 1 divided by 5 minus 1 in 200, and you got the number 50. For calculation of the latent variable score, which shows the performance of the constructs, which is an average performance of the constructs, you need to have is unstandardized outer ways also besides rescale indicator values. How to calculate those unstandardized outer weights? For the calculation of the unstandardized outer weights, we have to divide standardized weights by the standard deviation of its respective indicator. The standardized outer weights originate from the standard PLS path model estimation. The estimation of the each indicator standard deviation is based on the original indicator data. After determining the unstandardized outer weight, we have to rescale it. For rescaling, we have to divide each indicator unstandardized weight by the sum of the unstandardized weight of all the indicators that belong to the same measurement model. For example, for our first predecessor construct or latent variable, if there are 4 indicators for our latent variable, and so we have to find the unstandardized weight for individual indicator, and we have to determine divide it by the sum of the unstandardized weight of all the remaining indicators in the same measurement model. In that way, we can get the rescaled outer weights, unstandardized outer weights value. Now, by the linear combination of these rescaled unstandardized outer weights and indicator value for individual indicator of the model, we can determine the latent variable, average latent variable score for each construct or predecessor construct. And so we have to multiply the indicator value with a rescaled unstandardized outer weight for each indicator belongs to one measurement model. Then we have to sum these values for all the indicators for the same measurement model, and thus we can determine the average latent variable score approximate value for each of our latent variable. Step 3 comprise of the important values determination. As we know that that in terms of predicting another directly or indirectly linked target construct in the structural model, the construct importance is determined by determining the total effect, which comprise of both direct and indirect effects. So we have to add all these effects. Suppose in our case, GW is directly affecting WE and also affecting indirectly through SI and RI. To determine the total effect, we have to add direct effect and both of the indirect effects. So after determining this, we will go for the running of our model. Always remember, the smart PLS always give you all those calculations, and you don't need to find it out, because by smart PLS we got these latent variable scores and we got these unstandardized rescaled total effects also on the y-axis, and the performance on the y-axis and unstandardized total effects on the x-axis. So this graph shows that with one unit increase in the performance of your predecessor construct, the performance of the target construct increased by the size of the importance or total effect of the predecessor construct. And we can say that suppose if our performance of our ED, which is one of the predecessor construct, is increased by one unit, it will increase the target construct performance by 0.380 unit, which is the size of the unstandardized total effect. Thank you.